Yesterday you attended class on service tax. Which, first one or second one? How many students are there? Second? Nearly 100, ah? Enga, for second, yeah? ஃபுல்லா ஜாம் பேக்கடா ரெண்டையும் சேர்த்து அங்கே எடுக்க முடியுமா? எப்போ எல்லாம் ஊருக்கு போகிறாங்க? Reporting currency. Foreign currency. Friends, everybody, good morning. Happy Monday. Listen friends, we were actually discussing on to foreign branch or branch accounts. We have completed dependent branch and independent branch. The next segment of discussion in the branch accounts is foreign branch, for which the prerequisite is information about or understanding about AS 11. AS 11, the effects of changes in foreign exchange rates. AS 11, the effects of changes in foreign exchange rates, covers accounting for foreign currency transaction, translation of the information reported in foreign currency into reporting currency, domestic currency, which is normally called in the language of standard as reporting currency, accounting for forward contract. This is a derivative instrument. It will be learned in your final level SFM chapter, one such topic called forward contract. When you learn that, how to apply AS 11 there is what we will like to learn. Understood? So that is not within the ambit of IPCC. But we do have accounting for foreign currency transaction and translation. Shall we? So we have fixed the coverage in that there are only two discussions we have to have. Accounting for foreign currency transaction, translation of the information in foreign currency into reporting currency. Let us identify what exactly these meant. What will be the difference, or what will we do in accounts, what will we do in translation? Let me tell you that the first one and second one, the first segment and second segment, both actually involves translation. Both are translation. Are you following this? So we find accounts means it is not to be immediately the standard conveying some journal entry, some ledger posting, or maybe the required recognition of asset liability, nothing like that sort. Understood? So then what is that accounts? There also it is only translation. Here also it is only translation. Both are translation. Then why do you have two different topics? Why do you one called as accounts and the other called as translation? The first part is translation, but it is involving real-time translation. And the second part is not real-time translation. It is translation made only at the event of preparing financial statements. The first translation is as and when transaction happens, translate. Transaction occurs, translate. So like that you will translate the first part. The second part, friends, it will be translated only when we prepare what? Financial statements. Only on the event of preparing financial statements, we translate. Could you appreciate that? To give more insight into that. So because unless you know what they are, so then there will be difficulty in understanding. Let us learn that, shall we? So imagine there is a business enterprise operating in a particular country. Everybody, it is making few transaction alone in foreign currency. The country in which the business is operated, everybody, the currency of that country will be called as reporting currency, and we are making some transactions in foreign currency. To be even more precise, let that be a business enterprise in India. Why I am telling this? Now the standard is not telling that rupee as a reporting currency. Anything can be reporting currency. Could you appreciate that? So anything other than reporting currency is foreign currency. Shall we proceed? So your financial statements will be based on a one currency, which we should not be having assets in dollar, liability in rupees. Like that you can't have, correct Appa? So the statement, the currency based on which the statement is prepared is reporting currency. Any currency other than reporting currency is foreign currency. Shall we proceed? Now imagine in our country an enterprise is operating in India as the base, making all transaction in rupees. Please respond Pa. It makes one or two sales in dollars. It making one or two. So when we make so many transactions, thousands of transactions, we have made the immediate recording in rupees. Now this transaction has been billed as $40,000. We have sold the goods, we are preparing a bill, they are requiring the bill only in dollars, so we are billing them $40,000. Please respond. In our books, can we record debtors to sales $40,000? No. It has to be in immediately. That $40,000 should be converted into, even though money is not received, even though dollar is not only sales made, but for accounts purpose I want the equivalent value of $40,000. Could you appreciate that? So the translation made in the event of the accounting for transaction, that is what we call it as accounting for foreign currency transaction. But what is actually involved is the accounting standard doesn't say what is the sales entry. Please respond friends. Accounting standard doesn't say that when you should recognize the sales. Accounting standard says what value should record that sales. Could you appreciate that? Respond. It cannot be $40,000. It has to be in rupees. At what rate that $40,000 should be translated? It is the expected money of collection, or what is the rate you should be using? That is what conveyed through first part. What is that? Accounting for foreign currency transactions. Now what is this, sir? Imagine this country is having, or the business operating in this country is having a branch in US. Respond. Now goods are sold to a US customer and the billing is made in dollar. Not only billing is made in dollar, accounts also prepared in dollar. Money is collected in dollars. All the transaction happening there are in dollars. They prepare journal dollar, ledger in dollar, trial balance in dollar. They prepare their individual financial statement in dollar. But when we prepare our financial statements, we don't prepare financial statements for head office separately, branch separately. That is for internal purpose. For outside reporting, if there is a company called Infosys company, that company has to present its financial statement as a whole. So I have to compile the information of various branches in various country into this rupees. Yes, for that compilation, each and every trial balance items will be converted into reporting currency. Are you following? That is what we are going to learn under. So is it getting translated when the transaction is made, or some other point of time? Some other point of time. Which time? When we prepare financial statements. Correct? Here, we make the transaction directly. At the time of transaction, we convert it. Yes, sir. So actually, both are involving translation, and this is real-time translation. What do you mean by real-time? Na? The moment transaction occurs, immediately translate it. Understood? So here, transaction occurred, journal entry made, accounts made in foreign currency, and it will be settled, collected, everything in foreign currency. Sir, when we prepare financial statement, take the trial balance and convert it to reporting currency. Is that clear to you, friends? Now we have a clear cut understanding of the difference between accounting for First of all, why we learn difference? Because I told you both are same. What way they are same? Both involves translation. But one is on the transaction to transaction translation. The other one is information to information. Suppose debtors. We sold goods for debtors. Raj, we have sold goods to the debtors for $1 lakh. How much? $70,000 was collected. Respond. So debtors will show? $70,000 already collected. Debtors will show? $30,000. Correct. So in case of translation, we translate debtors only for $30,000. But had it been a direct transaction, then I would have translated for 1 lakh. Later on, money collected, that time translation. Then for the balance debtors, one more translation, like that it will go on. Understood.